10 years ago, while still in the operating room, I asked the surgeon to show me what he had removed. Before my sleepy eyes, he placed a vial containing what looked like a bloody pea, a small piece of me that was about to seal my fate. If I was lucky, the tumors that a recent CAT scan had revealed would be benign. Unlucky, and I was facing cancer. And somewhere in a remote area of the hospital, a pathologist I would never meet, who couldn't possibly know how much I wanted to live, would decide whether I was lucky or unlucky. So when a scan indicates a suspicious mass, what's the next step in identifying if it's malignant or not?
So if a patient has a scan, CT scan or an MRI, that shows something that shouldn't be there, the question then is, what's the nature of that? Just seeing a mass doesn't mean that it's malignant. And so it is critical to obtain a biopsy of that mass. We make the determination of whether it's cancerous, malignant, or benign by looking at it under the microscope. So when a surgeon or a clinician does a biopsy of a mass, they will send it to the Department of Pathology. And in pathology, they have specialists who look at masses or biopsies from different organ systems. In the best of all worlds, the surgeon or clinician will have already have spoken with the pathologist to determine what type of biopsy, how the biopsy should be done, how it should be sent to pathology, so all of the most appropriate tests can be done on that sample.
The type of the biopsy does impact the ability to render a diagnosis.
In terms of the types of biopsies, one is what's called a fine needle aspiration. In that procedure, a needle is attached to a syringe and placed into the mass, and cells are basically sucked out of the mass, individual cells. That procedure will allow us to tell if there are carcinoma cells there, cancerous cells of a solid tissue, basically, or an epithelium, lining of the GI tract or the respiratory tract. It's also can give us an idea if there is a malignancy of the blood system or the immune system, so-called leukemias and lymphomas. That can be used as a first step in looking at those. But for final diagnosis of cancers of the blood-forming system or the immune system, so leukemias and lymphomas, especially lymphomas, you typically need to get a biopsy that looks at the architecture of the tissue.
The excisional biopsies offer you an opportunity to evaluate the entire architecture of the specimen that's being submitted. Now, architecture is important because it gives you an opportunity to evaluate the cells in the context of its environment. To put it this way, if you saw a large number of cells that do not belong in a particular compartment, you start to ask yourself some questions about what are they doing there. If you now take a closer look at the cells and you see that they exhibit malignant characteristics, then you start to imagine, well, these cells look malignant and they are no longer where they should be. Normal tissues are organized, and they're organized in an organized way, curiously. It's important to assess the relationship between the cells and its environment. The way to do that is to have a tissue material that provides you with the opportunity to evaluate that relationship. If you were to assess the individual cells and not know what they're doing within the environment, it becomes difficult to contextualize their cancerous nature.
Cancers can occur in a variety of tissues and organs, and those tissues and organs have different functions, and the appearance of those normal tissues under the microscope tell you what that tissue is doing. So for example, tissues, cells that line the skin, the GI tract, the respiratory tract, the urinary tract, cells that are part of glands, those organs are made up of cells that are related to each other. In other words, they stick together. They have junctions that keep them together. What we're talking about when we say architecture is that we can see how those cells are bound to each other in a carcinoma, cancer of one of those types of tissues. On the other hand, in lymph nodes, the organ of the immune system, the cells have a different relationship to each other, and the appearance of the relationship in the cancerous tissue is very important in telling us what type of tumor it is. One of the most important questions an oncologist will ask of the pathologist before assigning therapy is how confident they are in the diagnosis based on the adequacy of the specimen received.
What do you expect the results of the biopsy to tell you?
An assessment has to be made of, was the right tissue biopsied? Okay, so sometimes we get back a report saying that the biopsy appears normal, and yet we know that there's something abnormal in that tissue, and a clinician, a physician taking care of a patient, has to make the decision of whether the right piece of tissue was actually obtained in the biopsy. So sometimes we request a second biopsy if the results just don't make any sense. But if the biopsy is done correctly of the right organ, it tells us if it's an inflammatory mass, just cells of the immune system invading in terms of some side of infection or autoimmune disease, a number of different things can cause that, or if it is due to a malignant growth of cells of that organ. And if that's the case, then specifically what type of malignancy? Cancer is not just one disease. It is multiple diseases of multiple organs.